Jared Polin, froknowsphoto.com. And in just a few minutes, I'm going to turn around and start editing all of the photos from my recent 5-minute portrait with the Canon 80D and 18-135 kit lens. So while the 1-to-1 previews are finishing up, let me tell you what I'm going to do. When I turn around, I'm going to edit each one of the keeper images, but you're gonna see all the pictures I shot. You're gonna see exactly what I do when I come back from a photo shoot and rename everything, select the keepers, and then edit the keepers. I'm gonna walk through that process. So I say buckle your safety belts, because this is probably gonna be a pretty long video, because you're gonna be here watching over my shoulder as if you're sitting here in my loft right now watching me edit each of the photos. Now, I may not talk as much as I normally do, I probably will, but I'm gonna go through the images, tell you what may have been on my mind when I was shooting, and why I'm making the decisions and choices that I'm doing. But this is what this is about. It's about watching me do my edits so that you can pick up some nuggets of information to see if it can help you edit. But really, that's it. Let's turn around and get to editing.
All right, are you guys ready? Like I said, it's gonna probably be a pretty long video because there's 342 pictures here. I just got done doing the 1-to-1 previews. I highly recommend that you do 1-to-1 previews when you're about to start to edit so that you don't have to wait for each one to zoom in. Like, you don't have to wait for it to process when you zoom in. That's the importance of 1-to-1. Now, I have it personally set that the 1-to-1s will disappear after 30 days. They'll be deleted, because if you don't do that, you're gonna clog up your computer with a lot of files. So for anybody that doesn't know, I'm currently working in Adobe Lightroom. That's what I personally use myself. I've been using it since Adobe Lightroom 1.0. That's what, since 2003, when I got my first digital, no, not 2003. Whenever they first introduced it, I started using it, and I've been using it ever since. So I like doing these editing videos. If you like me doing these editing videos where you get to see the entire walkthrough process, they are long, but I think you guys enjoy them, and I also think they're helpful. If you do enjoy them, please give it a thumbs up. Please be sure to share it out with other people. Also, subscribe on YouTube to be notified when all my videos go live. Plus, subscribing helps. And also follow me on Facebook if you want. So here's what I'm going to do first. I'm going to go ahead and Command A to select everything, Function F2, and this is going to be so that I can rename all of the images. So I've got the date is what I like to do, 2016-07. Today is 06 on the watch. 2016-07-06 underscore. We'll call it Norman Porter. That's the name of the shop. I have another underscore and then 001 because there's under 1,000 pictures. Go ahead and hit the OK button. You can see that it's propagating, and I have all of the file names now go in order. So what I normally do is I go through and I start to star the images that I think are the good ones. Now, this was at the very beginning. What you have to understand is I was making the 5-minute portrait, so I was working through the process of getting the photos right, getting my exposure right, and this was the first one that I took. And the funny thing is, what I do is I go through these images like this. See, I got my exposure right, I also got my lines right, and this became a much better image. Excuse me. In terms of focus, remember this is 19 millimeters, so zooming in like this, it is sharp. Sharp down here as well, and this is not processed. I turn off the noise reduction in the camera, even though that wouldn't affect my raw files. I'm actually going to give this a number. So the way that I do numbers, I hit 5 to 5-star, the ones that I'm going to edit. The ones that I really, really like at the end become 6, so they get red. This is personal preference. You can hit any number that you want. You could make this a 1. You could make it a 2. I personally make the ones that I want a 5 to edit, and then I go back and tweak from there. So even though this is underexposed, I'm pretty sure we can bring it back, and I like the angle that I have with the shears kept in there. So I'm going to go through. You see how the line looks much better with this one? So I'm going to make an edit with that. The fan is moving. I'm wondering which one is better. See, these are the things that you do. So in the meantime, I'll just keep them both till I decide. Fighting with the backlight is one thing. I'm going to keep it for now. Yeah, cutting up the stuff. I love this 5-minute portrait. Oops, got to kill my email box. Goodbye, email box. I don't want anything from Touch of Modern right now. Shoo, email box. Good, gone. Very tough to shoot into the backlight. Tough for focusing. That one's not in. then we get this nice light coming off the side here. I love this. Don't worry about the noise and grain. This is 2000 ISO, but again, zoomed all the way in. I love detail shots of everything going on in this, so that's why we have that. Keep in mind, kit lens, cursed. I love the contrast. What I like about this is how he's framed with this stuff behind him. I didn't do that on purpose. I mean, yes, I probably subconsciously did it, but didn't realize that this light poly thing was here, and he's being framed by the windowsill. Awesome. This is a nice shot. I love this shot. I didn't actually tell him to hold on this, but that's a really cool shot. So a lot of stuff that I'm keeping in mind with this for these candids is what's going to look good in a book. I'm going to make him an Adorama Pix photo book, just like I did with Bedia, and I'm going to take it to him, and we'll record his feelings. So hopefully there's so many good pictures that it's going to take me a while to edit. So I get the wides, the tights. I like this because he's got movement going on. See, what I do is I work my way in. You can see just working my way through the 18 to 135. This is going to take a while because I like talking. But we start all the way out here and work our way in. So I like this one. I like the framing. Cool. Get the elbows in, frame edge to edge. Where do I like his head? Do I like this, this, or this? Yes, he's wearing a microphone, by the way, but that's just part of the shoot. I like the exposure better there. Did I change it? 1/250th of a second, 1/400th of a second. Yeah, so I made a quick correction. Oh, I made the quick correction because as you zoom out, it's a variable aperture lens. I'm not supposed to be teaching so much here. I like this. I like this. This is blocking that light, which is good, but it's a little awkward with his neck. I like this. Ooh, I like the way his arms are here. So I did take a lot of pictures. Well, I only took 342. That's not bad. I got the steam. I don't even know if I asked him. No, I didn't ask him because look. Oh, yeah. I got some hand motion going on here. That's cool. There's nothing. There is stuff cooler than that, but I like doing that. So I got the hand motion and the steam, which is cool. Changing my angles. Love the details in the background. Oh, God. So much better. See, this is, by the way, this is the first time I'm seeing these images is with you. I haven't seen them. The only time I saw some of them, back of the camera. So this is cool. Higher angle, lower angle. Higher angle, lower angle. Boom. I got the steam. Look at the steam rising. I got chills. They're multiplying. And I'm losing control of the... Usually I listen to music when I do this. Ooh, this one's even better, but there's no steam. Whatever, I like it. I'm going to... A little too low. See? I was a little too low, then I got myself up a little higher angle, but I'm going to keep that. This will be... Look, these will be a lot easier to edit together because they're very similar. Ooh, yeah! Hello! Oh, I cut his fingers off, but that's okay. It's not really okay, but I'll live with it because my focus went right to his face. This is a detailed shot I talk about. I'm actually going to have to edit all the images at some point so that Steven can use them in the video, so I'll have to go back and do that. This is interesting. Then I just spent time looking at the shears, so I'll do that, yeah, because you got him in the background out of focus. In the video, you see me talk about cutting off this stuff here, and then I corrected it by not cutting it off. I like this shot. Let's give that a 6 right now. I should have been doing that all along. Is it sharp? Not really. We'll see. We'll give it another look. We'll see if we can get away with it or not. But you can clearly see that's not really sharp for whatever reason. I left IS on the whole time. Hopefully that wasn't a problem or stupid. Hopefully it wasn't stupid, but I left it on. So it doesn't get a 6 anymore. But this is much better. Yeah, that's better. Oh, that's even better. Love this one. The man at work. I love their custom jeans. Go check them out. NormanPorter.com. So part of it's not getting too close and shooting everything super wide, because you want to get some other cool shots. Detailed shots. Oh, interesting. Japanese and American. Because I think they get some fabric from other countries. This, I forgot to bring my mono iPod and I was holding it up. I don't really like this photo that much. But I do like these if I didn't have his microphone pack there. It's just because we talked to him. I'm keeping it. I don't care. Microphone pack's there. Then I love stuff like this. That is sharp. Just remember, 27 millimeters, and I'm zooming in 1:1. This is going to be sharp all day long. Yes. I spy Todd hiding in the corner right here, by the way. I don't care. Todd, get the fuck out of my picture. Oy, oy, oy. I'm going to... Oh, what a... Oh. Oh, yeah. Look at this guy. I'm going to get in your picture, Jared. I'm going to be all creepy with my creepy glasses. Whatever. I love using... See, that's sharp. I love using the things out of focus in the foreground to draw me in to the stuff at a distance. See, some of this stuff is better for video. Now, you get great video with this camera. We have all the samples, so I like this one better. Oh, change my exposure. That's even better. So goodbye that one. Hello that one. And then he raised his arm, so that's what I was looking for. As you can see, this takes time, right? That was probably me talking to him. No, we can't use it. You have to be the guys that choose what to use and what not to use, and that's not a good shot because of the way he's looking. But look at all the out-of-focus layers of stuff that I'm using to make this into a three-dimensional photo. That's what you need to do. I don't know if this is good or not. Not really. It's boring when it comes to a still. I don't know. Maybe that's cool. The hands, that could be used for something. Hands. Touching hands, reaching out, touching me, touching you. Again, I usually listen to music when I do this. Actually, you got all these moving, so I'll just edit them real quick for Steven. That's cool. I love, look at this. Union Special. Oh, yeah. You can just see the sharpness. It's sharper because I'm closer. So, again, with the 1:1, if it was going in even further, it wouldn't look like that. So we're going to go with that. I love these. Even though this light is there, you can see 1:1 at a distance. That's just what happens. I asked him to look at me. It's just about finding your angles. And I say this during the video, but... I don't care what you're using in terms of glass and lenses and bodies, but, you know, I use... This is what I shot with because it's a challenge. But on the flip side, I do use the top-of-the-line Nikon or not top-of-the-line Canons and glass because it allows me to pull more out of it that I can pull out of it because I know what I'm doing. So these, I got my exposure wrong because he moved closer to the light, but I'm going to go ahead and bring it back. It should come back fine. Let me just switch over into the develop module real quick. And it comes back because of the raw file. Off by almost 2 stops is not a great place to be. But I don't care. It worked. So it worked. Back into the library. Just wanted to see that we could do that. And then you can see I got my exposure a little better. Eyes, all about the eyes. This one's better because his eyes were half closed there. There, he's looking down at the fabric. Ooh, there's just something different. The spool of thread. I wanted this shot, so I took it. So you can see that it's actually moving. So where is it better? And you can see it's moving here. My goal was to get him out of focus on the side while getting this photo right here. Didn't like this angle. Love this angle. Norman Porter. I asked him to look out the window. I did. I really did. The keys. I thought it was pretty cool little thing going on there. The workbench. Detailed shots. Shots that could be used. So let me show you something. This is 18 millimeters. This is 35 millimeters. That's 62. So you see how you go from the bowing right down here to less bowing? That's, I backed up and did this. And then this is should be around 50. It is 50 millimeters. Just details. So then I saw the shears here, and I'm like, oh, I should shoot the shears tight and get him out of focus in the background. That's better. It's tighter. Then get some verticals because a lot were horizontals. And this was showing you guys that at 18 millimeters, you absolutely can blow the background out. I just love that he's working back there. Then I went up to 5.6 to blow the background out. Well, to get more in focus, but still blow the background out. Yes, I got the Norman Porter in there. That was changing my exposure. This is it. This is it. This is the shot that you want. Him in the background, out of focus, doing his things, and this in the foreground. You can see now I'm at f5. Look at the bokeh on the background and tell me that the kit lens isn't capable of doing it, right? Then I went to 6.3. I went even further. And it's still blowing out. I just wanted to get him a little more in focus. So I like this one over this one because I gave him more headroom. Let me just see which one where the focus is better. Yeah, that's great. Love this shot. I like that one too. Then we go vertical. Cut off this, which makes this not a usable shot. This one doesn't cut off. Good. Then we did some portraits. Portraity ones, that's not in focus. I prefer the Candidy portraits better, what I was getting. These are just, I said it during the video, that these are just basically headshots. They suck after a while because it doesn't give you all the ambiance of what's going on in here. That's a little distracting up here. Didn't notice it when I was shooting. So the lens is fine. This stuff is fine. Moved over to the workbench. Boom. Light's better right there. Using all natural light. Just wait till I edit this stuff, guys. See, still like, even though it's tighter, we still have him in his natural working environment. It's pretty sharp. Not bad at all. I talked about his other hand. There we go. I brought it up. Cross his arms back. Nice. Pretty happy with this stuff. Threw him off to one side. I like this too. Like, leave me alone. I'm trying to work here, Jared. Guy with the hair. Yeah, switched angles. This one's better. That's good. Not exactly centered, but that's the point. Just slightly off center. And then ultra wide. I like to run through all the different scenarios, guys. You know that. Then I move this. Watch. I had nothing there. Then I move some of the jeans right there. Then I wanted to get some B-roll. Then he was just hanging out, grabbing a snack. And actually just grab some candids that are not in focus, as we can see. Why are they not in focus? I'm not sure. I don't know if it's a combination of the light or where the lens was or what, but that's better. Fabric-y stuff. It's good for details. Chicago. I don't know that I like that so much, but then we move into the videos, and I think that's all for the stills. So what I do next is I go, I hit number 5. We've got how many selected? 151 of 342. Not bad at all. How far in are we? I need to take a look. 20 minutes in. Not bad. Let's keep on going. You guys enjoying this? Let's get some comments. So that's the process I go through. And then I may go through tomorrow and come back and look again. Now we get into what I do is the edit. So each individual image gets tweaked. That's why they're shot raw, because you have to do that. Pump up my exposure, go with my contrast a little bit. We're going to go with the black and white and colors a lot, I think, for this. Steven was telling me, he's like, you're probably going to go black and white for a lot of this stuff. Don't forget, we've got all this. Not going to go strong here. It's too strong. Go to medium. Go like that just a little bit. Tweaky McTweakerson of this stuff. I love just moving my sliders to see the results. The white balance looks pretty good. See, the thing is, when you're shooting, I say it during the video, I don't give a shit what you're shooting with. If yeah, you can bitch about using the lowest end gear that you have and all of that stuff, but it's about what you do with it. And when I have a camera in my hands, I don't care what I have. I'm going to use it to the best of the ability that I can, whether it's a point and shoot, whether it's a cell phone, or whether it's this 80D with a kit 18-135. Would I have preferred to switch to my 24-70 2.8 and a 70-200 and a 14-24? Absolutely. But at the end of the day, when I print this book and print the photos and show them online, only people that are super technical are going to be like, oh, what'd you shoot that with? Most people are like, that's a cool photo. I know the differences between the two, the sharpness and things like that. But personally, yeah, I don't care. Whatever I was saying. Again, this is 1:1, people. Remember, that's like 24 megapixels. This is zoomed in 1:1. This is what it would look like to fill the frame. Keep in mind, 1:1 is as if you were printing a huge-ass shot and putting it out into the world. Oh, Steven, what the hell are you doing in my frame? I don't care. I'm using it. Damn it. See, that's the tough thing, is when I'm doing a real shoot, these guys are trying, their job is to get the video, and my job is to get the photos. It is what it is. They're going to show up in the background. That's part of what I do. Oh, God, yes. I love you, black and white. And this is cool, too, because his back is to the light, and I'm still getting this shot right here. Let's see what the color would look like. Ah, damn it. The color's pretty good. The color's pretty good. And like I said, I may come back tomorrow, and I may end up sitting here going, you know what? I like the black and white better. And we'll see what the final thoughts are when I go back. But you can see that I got the exposure wrong on this. 1.75 stops, and this is much closer. Command Z, go back. Highlights, you can always do that. Really not too much needed here. Pull back a little bit. You can do this, but I don't want to oversaturate anything. I could also punch up, say, watch this. We could take all the blues out. You could punch the blues up even further, but we'll just leave them natural to where they came out of the camera. So being that this image is taken at the same as this image, I'm only 3 images in. I better speed the hell up. Sync. Boom. This one synced. Which one's better? Lower angle's better. Yeah, this one's better. Let me tell you why it's better. It's not because just Steven's in it. It's because, look, I didn't cut off the shears there, but I cut off the shears here. They're very similar images. But I like the one. What do you guys think? With the shears all the way in or with the shears all the way? All right, I'm going to have to keep them both right now because I think they're both strong. Let me get back to fit. That was an accident. Color also isn't going to be needed on this shot. I don't think that this shot's going to be usable. I don't like it. The horizontal just works better in this case. This is where your black and white's going to shine. There's not a lot of color here, so So I'll make all the edits. I'm going to have to do them anyway. And then I can come back and really select the keepers, the Kiefer Sutherlands. I wouldn't usually go through all of these at once either. It's just because you guys are watching, I'm here doing it. That variable aperture lens thing is still a pain in the ass to work with. That's where it started. This is where we're at. I'm going to have to really play this game of color or black and white. But what I can do, same exposure. See, if they're the same exposure, then I really can just sync them. Because they're going to be very similar. Yeah, that's a great shot. That's a great shot right there. Ah, shit. It looks good in black and white. Ah, shit. It looks good in color. This is the dilemma. That's why I give you guys the ability to download the RAW files and try for yourself. And then I'll go through, I'll sit, well, I have to make the final decision. I almost said I'll sit with the team, but I really got to go with what's in my gut. There's your color, there's your black and white. Yeah, I like it darker like that. Good. What's stronger, guys? Color or black and white? Whew. We got to move on. I love the black and whites. I really, really do. I'm just going to make both right now because I'll come back later and I'll look at it with fresher eyes after I'm done eating Betty a pizza. See, that can bring the windows down outside, but I don't want to do that. Color may be better on this one. I also try not to go too far with the shadows. Boom. Contrast. Levels. Or, sorry, tone curve. See, there's a lot of cool browns in here, and especially in the ceiling as well. Highly reflective. Pull down on that a little bit. White a little bit. Jesus. I love the black and white. It just, from a distance, it looks better in black and white. From a distance, the world is old and blue. Ya-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da. So this is Mike with Norman Porter. Norman Porter was named, I believe, after their grandfather. He and his brother run this business. They also make cool cabinets for guitars. Exposure is changing. Yeah, the exposure is changing, but let's sync one and see what it looks like. Wow. Talk about, you can always hit reset. Talk about the colors changing. I actually like the colors that it was giving me. I may need to warm it up, so let's sync it up. Hey, look, we're about 8 pictures in, guys. I definitely don't want to rush through this because I know you guys like this, so I don't want to rush. And I also don't want to overdo some of the processing. Yes, it looks dark, but that's the scene that we were in. I like that. I really do. And yeah, my exposure's off just a little bit. Jesus. I mean, the color looks stronger to my eyes right now. What I gotta say is from this 80D, I actually think that's done a great job with the auto white balance. Yeah, I think it's done a fantastic job. I want you guys to remember when you're printing that what you're looking at here on the screen has backlight through it, that your prints are going to come out darker because they don't have backlight. So I sometimes up at a quarter of a stop to compensate for the lack of light shining through when we get the print made. Right now I feel the color, but I'll make a duplicate. I create virtual copies so that I have two in the line, so when I print it, sorry, when I export it, I've got both the color and the black and white there. Also, Steven can use it when editing. So this is better than this. This is going. So this is what happens when you start going through. Like, these are not strong. That's not a strong shot. This isn't really super strong either. So let's see what else we have coming there. That's even better. This is not, it's not actually that bad. This can be darker because of the scene that it's in. There's a lot of light around. I don't know. I'm just speaking just to speak, guys. I don't actually want to bring that stuff in from outside. I want I want it to be mostly blown out. Probably won't be used as well, but these are starting. This is where it's really good. I'm using the clarity to tighten it up. It's another form of contrast. Look how that face just tightened up too. Watch this. I do no noise reduction. For anybody wondering, I do none. And when you print it out, you won't even notice noise. This is sweet. Checking time. 31 minutes in. Man, that black and white is solid also. That shot's not as good. I already saw it. Color may be better there. That one's not as good. Just whatever, this one looks better. That's not as good either, but I will edit it anyway. It's a little too harsh. Some people will yell at me. It's nice. How many in are we, guys? How many have I done so far? 20 of 151. Oy, 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 oy. I guess less talking, more editing. I don't want to do that. I'm actually going to bring this one down a little bit. It's meant to be a little darker. Got to remember the light's not bouncing up into his face here. And I won't lie to you. It doesn't look to be super duper sharp, but I don't know why. Is it more on the hand? See, I don't understand why that happens. That I don't understand. I know that I put my focus point right on him. You can see it in the video. Is it usable? Probably. Most people would never notice it other than me showing it to you. But that's why I make these videos. So cool. Being that these are all the same, I can get a good starting point and go from there. Shit. I always confuse. I say shit because it's like, oh, damn it, that looks good in black and white. Hard to say. I'm going to stick with the color. What's going on? There we go. Don't forget, I'm running ScreenFlow right now, so that's probably chewing up some of the processing power. I like this shot. Watch. Yeah, you need to actually pull back on those highlights. Pull back on the exposure. Tighten that up a little bit. Oh, shit. Damn it. That's great. And that's great in both. I'm just going to do this, and I'll decide later, guys. I just have to do that for time purposes. Hands reaching out. A lot of this we probably want to keep the denim color, so that's why some of them will remain in color, because it's important to have the blue denim. All right, good. We can go through that much quicker. This is a stupid picture, Jared. This is all right. I know I have better ones later on, so I'm not really going to spend too much time right here. We know we have better ones later on. I like the head down better. This one, goodbye. I do. I like the head down better. Oh, this is that really good one that I like that's not super sharp. Being honest here. I think this could work in black and white. Yep, I was right. It's all the stuff in the background. I do. It looks cool in color. Oh, but I feel this one in black and white. It comes down to a personal feel. Because I love all the details, but how's it in color? Shit. I talked about the denim. Denim is important. Fuck it. I'll do both. Let's go with that. Boom. That's a nice black and white. I just wish that was sharper. Oops. Undo whatever I just did. Well, undo whatever I just did. Sync. That's sharper. Ah, that's beautiful. I'm happy with that. Again, the blue jeans. That's got to be why you got to keep some of this stuff in color. As I go to black and white. That's sharp. I wonder why you couldn't get all of them super duper sharp like this. Don't forget, temperature can also tweak your black and white. Excuse me. All right, we'll just sync that. Ooh, not so much. That's not a good picture. Just not a good picture. Or maybe it is, I don't know. Boom. Cool. My dad was just calling, but I'm editing. I'll call him back. I think the black and white's going to be better here. Shit, I don't know if it's better. I do think I went too far with the contrast. You McContrasterson on that one, though. Black and white's better. I'm making that call right now. This will also look good as a two-page spread because it's going to go right through here. This is the center, right around here. So that will look good. Oh, that's good. Clappy my hands. I'm clapping my hands. Of course, we got a bunch of the same. I can go back and I can pull back just a little bit if I want them to be in. Ooh, yeah. I just think that pops. Look at his face pop in black and white. Because he actually has this light on it. Todd, get out of my picture, buddy. It's a shame, because I refuse to crop. Interesting to have his back to the light, the window light, and still able to get good shots. This looks like a fish. I'm an eyeball and I'm a mouth. Sometimes this one's forcing me to go into black and white. I actually took a break after 40-some minutes and ate a pizza. It was really good. Okay, back to editing. As we have already gone for some 40-some minutes. Now I'm refreshed and now it's dark out. Let's keep on going. I got hair on the microphone. Look at that. It's mine. Just looking for the right angle here, the right edit. It does take a while to edit. I probably would have done this in cycles, meaning I wouldn't have sat here and done 155 all at once. But like I said, I'm doing this because of you guys. You want to see it? I'm going to give it to you. I'm going to give it to you good. Let's see if this is a color or black and white because of the way that the light is hitting his face. Don't think it's a black and white because of that. What I can do here is because of that orange, I can come down here and I can remove some of that orange, you see? I'm going to just pull back on it slightly so it's not that prevalent and in his face as much. That way it's better. Just waiting for it to load. That looks good. Mm-mm. Color doesn't work. I mean, black and white doesn't work, in my opinion, on this one. I'm definitely going to pull out some of that orange again. There we go. Not really feeling this that much, but whatever. Needs to be edited. Boring. But who knows? You never know when this stuff can be used or what it can be used for, so it doesn't hurt to have that as a B-roll. So these are all going to end up being the same. Should be the same exposure. I took multiple frames a second. Probably going to have to do the same thing here. Pulling out that orange gives it an oldie-timey look, but it still works. Just looking to see if anything changed. That looks good. That's sweet. I like what's going on in this image. Damn it. Do I like that more or not? It's funny. Like, black and white just looks... Damn it. They're both good. It's just what I was going to say is black and whites tend to look less like snapshots because people aren't used to seeing them as much. Now, they do see them a little more today. No, I still liked it darker. I don't know. It's very hard to say. Let's sync those up. Just pull out some of that orange. Just a little bit of it, not too much. Just because I just think it's way too orange. So bringing down the saturation of that. Let's get some light up in the face right here. Lose some of it with that. I was almost ready to not use this, but... still think it works. Mm-hmm. Don't usually talk during my editing. This is an interesting one. so much I like it darker, because if you don't have it super dark, this white becomes really distracting in your face. I mean, really distracting. I just want to go up with the exposure just a little bit. A little too on the green side. It's actually not bad. It's why sometimes you hit sharpness and other times you don't is still beyond me with these cameras. That's cool. I actually like this. I cannot wait to turn this into a photo book and go do a reveal. I wonder if we should put the reveal in a separate video or put it in the same. I mean, it ends up being in a separate video, but I'm sure we could pull that off. Yes. No. Yes. No. I don't know. There, we'll go with that. Mm-hmm. Trouble. Da-da-da-da-da. Like I said, fly on the... Ah. What I was saying is, like, fly on the wall. You guys get to just watch. I'm just... I don't need to talk. I just need to edit. I just got rid of that one, getting rid of that one. So this is actually better because you can see what's going on. Obviously, he gets super close to his sewing machines. Color. Funny, as I move, I always say this, it's like guitar face. Guitarists have guitar face, I've got editing face. I'm like, please hold up. Oh, see, that's better. See, that's a little better of a shot, just because of where I was. And that's about the same. Why'd the exposure change on that? 1/250th? I don't know. Maybe sat back into the light a little bit. Let's see if one of these wide ones work better in black and white. Being that they're similar. Ah. That one's better than this one. This one's going. This one where I got the exposure wrong. I'll just bring it back in the raw file. Yeah, that looks good. Sweet. Happy with this one. Even though I screwed up the exposure, I'm happy that I was able to bring it back. And that's the joy of RAW. You try to get it as right as possible, and sometimes it just doesn't work. And then I got to decide now. Look how thick this is. Even though I got it wrong, it's super thick. I'm really happy with that. I'm going to pull out the orange again. Just a little bit. I like that. I like that a lot. You get a number 6. My exposure slightly off again. Not bad. Or not as bad. I know some people are always like, well, shouldn't you be in aperture priority so that you can, if the light changes, blah, blah, blah. I'm like, eh, sometimes maybe, but most of the time, no, because the light isn't going to change that much, and it's on me. Like, I don't want it to meter off of here by accident and totally give me this exposure. So that's why I shoot manual. Damn it. And I say damn it because it's a good picture, and again with the color. But what's good is I got a bunch of similar ones to help us get through them by syncing. Eyes. See, the eyes just make this so much better. I really don't know if this is any good, but it's not really any good. I don't know. I don't like it at all, but maybe somebody else does. I like this a lot. Nice details. I like that. I do. I like this one better than this one. I'm actually going to get rid of this one because I like the way that this is composed and framed much better. Don't worry. Don't worry. I'll tighten it up. I know. Still want to be able to read what's on the shirt. And I keep pulling back. Still can read it here, so. I'm just feeling that right now. Oh yeah, dude, that's good. I like the black and white on this one. This is so much better. That gets a number 6. It's much wider. You can still read that it says Norman Porter, Philadelphia, Pennsylvania. Nice. This is, ugh. Let's just sit back. Every once in a while, you just sit back and you look at a picture and it tells the story you want to tell. And this is one that does it. The one before, a little tighter. Not bad. The one after, more of a story. I like it. You get more of the scene in there. Boom. Yeah. You got to every once in a while stop and smell the roses or something. That's what I love about processing. I mean, I love the darkroom way back when, But when you can just sit here and process away, it's just super cool when you can do that. I don't like this one anymore. But what I'll do is I'll sync it to the last one, and we'll see if I do like it after it's processed quickly. Okay. Maybe. We'll go with it for now. That's really no good. It's just his keys and his car and his wallet. Not very good. But the rest of it is a little better. So this, pull back on the yellow a little bit. Oh, cool. You got all this stuff right here. I love when you pull out details that you didn't even know were there. When you shot them, that is. So the computer's probably just weighing itself down because of the screen flow that's going. How would the black and white be? Oh, I think something is the color lends to this one. I think the color works. I don't even like this, but maybe Todd, maybe somebody could use it in terms of the video as a plate or something. Ah, up to these shots. So that one's no good. This one's better. I think we can go with the black and white. I do. See, I like that angle better, but we'll edit it. Damn it. The damn it again is for the color versus black and white. For once, I can actually bring the highlights down. It's not a problem. Yeah, that's right. That's what I'm talking about. Huh. Black and white or color, guys. don't know. It just seems more authentic. Authentica in black and white. That is tight. I love how the light just shines, whatever, right in this area. Well, let's see if we can go harsh on this strong. Yep. Damn it. I see the merits. I do see the merits in the color. Definitely has to have the warm hue to it. But come on, what do we say? What do we do? I would love to get his opinion on this. I really would. And I like this one better because you see him working right there. We'll do the same thing. Duplicate. Sorry, create virtual copy. Go back to color. Damn, that's good as well. Damn. This is sweet. All done with a kit lens, people. Yes, I'm making this thick. Because I want it to look thick and warm and inviting. That's where the yellow comes into play. Just a little bit, just a smidge. Yeah. Well, not too much, Jared. God, we gotta go with both. We do. I'm gonna have to decide later, guys. I just have to. I'll probably come back tomorrow and be like, what am I going to do? God, that looks so thick and awesome. Thick to me is the contrast. Actually, I can pull the orange out. Again, gotta do it. I create that, like I said earlier. Why? Because it gives me two visuals opposed to stacking them. God, I love this. This is awesome. Kit lens, people. Of course, that gets me happy. The fact that you can prove to people time and time again that you can do it with a freaking kit lens. If you can do it with a kit lens, look what we're doing with a kit lens. Gonna do it again. Gonna have to decide later. Then we got these portraits. I liked him more so in the natural shots. This is cool though. Yeah, like I was saying earlier, or I said in the video itself, there's only so much you can do with these photos. I like the work photos so much better than this, but I wanted to make sure that we got some of the portrait setup shots for you guys to play with. They look pretty good right now. 1/125th, same exposure. We'll set these up and we'll see how they look. Just to do it, just to see what we could get. That's why these pictures are here. They're not my favorite, like I say in the video. Check out the video, you'll hear me say what I have to say about that. I'm gonna nix these as my favorites because they're not. They're set up. But I like the arms crossed more than anything. Now this is interesting lighting. That's not in focus. Goodbye. Don't worry. I got you. All right, just computer was stuttering for a minute. In essence, the same shot. Still here? Still sticking with us? Hashtag, I love these long-ass videos. That's if you like these long-ass videos. I'm saying I might as well share them with you if I'm going to be editing anyway. I might as well just hit record. Get some more information out of it. These are all going to be pretty similar. And I can see the daylight, guys. I can see us coming in to the end of the shots shortly. I'll probably get lazy near the end here, though I shouldn't get lazy near the end here. Computer's starting to go slow because of the screen flow. I'm starting to lose it a little bit. Don't know why the computer's doing that. I actually like that a lot, so I'm feeling the color on that. The ones with more detail obviously are much better. There's nothing in this image that screams exactly what he does because I cut the background mostly out. So that's what makes this not a good image. In my opinion, not a good image. There's not much going on. There's no detail. This has more detail. So it's a lot better. It's not great. It's still better. Yeah, I forgot about these. I hope I get a natural vignette on these. Damn it. I was hoping not to like black and white at all. Here, now I'm going to bring out the vignette. I like this. So I like all the stuff going on in the image. And what's good about this is it's set up for a two-page spread perfectly because the fold isn't going to go right down in the middle. So let's lock these in real quick. Let's also duplicate this into a black and white that I can crush even more. I'm well aware that I crushed this stuff. Yeah! I like that lower angle looking at us. Oh, that's sweet. They both look good. I can't deny the fact that those both look good. I should set a preset to make create a virtual copy. So when I'm looking at a black and white, by the way, when I'm processing, I'm looking at the face first and foremost. That's what I'm looking at mostly with what I'm editing. There, the black and white's good here. I think the color may have it out, though. I like that look. But these are good too. Don't like that one. Yes. God, amazing kit, man. Doing this with basic stuff. Now, this doesn't work as a two-page spread as much because he's right in the middle. The color's much better, not going to lie, on this one. You can see how the exposure drops because it went out to 4.5, and that one was F4. And this is a garbage picture, but oh, I'll just go through it. Why is it garbage? Because it's really not serving much of a purpose. Fireworks going off outside. All right, get out of here. I'm actually going to sync this with these. Should give me a good exposure. Not in focus. Don't like him biting the lip. No, we're going to get rid of that anyway. This stuff. I wonder how many people are still sitting here watching this. Just wanted to make sure it was actually working. Get out of here. I like the color on this one better anyway. How many asses have sat in this seat? Where am I focused? If I'm focused on him, it's a better shot. If I'm focused on the background, it's not good. I'm focused on him. Damn it. Well, that one's not as good. You don't have his eyes. Or is it? I don't know. We'll keep them both. We'll make one black and white and one color. This time I focused on the background. And that's it. That's all of them. And then I would go through and pick the best of the best of the best with honor, sir. Oh, I got Steven in the background. Actually, not that bad now that I look at it. Tells a nice little story for a backlit shot. Love this one. Torn between the two, of course. We'll go with this because it's a wide shot, though I don't know it works well in the book. It goes right down the middle. Like that. Steam. Still like that better, though. Which one? Steam or no steam? I just like the angle here better. The way that his shoulder in the back, see that? That just looks awkward. This looks less awkward. That's a great shot. I like the determination. I like that. I still like this. We have a couple of these to choose from. I love this for this, for the way that his eyes are looking up at this. And I hate that because Todd's in it. The light is just there. It's in that spot. There's nothing I could do about it. I do like that. That works well as well. I wonder if I like that he's looking at the light. Probably not, because the light isn't the jeans. I don't like that look, but I like that one better. It's softer. I don't get that photo, Jared. Ah, man. I like the wider one. Oh, it already had a red label on it? Still want to be able to read the Norman Porter, though. We could always go in there and touch it up more if we wanted. Oh, God. I know this is going to be a difficult one. So neither of these aren't as strong as that and that. Though, this and this are better because of where his face is. But I do like the way that the Norman Porter, I like the angle here. So we'll keep it. That's great. That's great. Shit, that's good. I like the angle here better than this. It's lower. I went to F6.3. Yep. I wanted more depth of field. I wanted more. I didn't want to just blow it out. Don't know that I like where the scissors are in this one. Already gave you my opinions on those. I like the arms crossed. I know he looks disinterested, but he wasn't. No, I actually don't like that. I like the color better. I love these. I think this is my favorite. Oh shit, I like that. Do I like that? Do I like the table? That one, right? That's good too. Oh, I like this. This is cool. That's cool. Shit. I think I like the color. Go with both of these for now. And no. So what we're going to do that. Go back to library mode. Sit back and take a look. It's in a book. It's reading rainbow. This is what you need to do when you get your photos done, is just sit back and take a look at the photo story. I don't know how many of these did I end up picking? 42 isn't bad. That will fill a nice book. I might probably go back and do another pass, but let's see how they all play along together. I still like that. I probably don't need both of these, so one of them may come out. But I still like this from the side. I really do. I love whatever this stuff's called. I like that. Yeah, I like that a lot. I don't give a shit that he's wearing our mic pack, because he is. It's part of the image. I love that. Holy shit, I love that. Oh, what I love is look at the details of the damn sewing machine here. I love the fact that I keep picking up details in this shot. And there's a punch clock on the wall. I like that. See, I like this as a tight shot. Remember when I said the headshots get boring if there's nothing going on? This, he's through the sewing machine as part of the photo story. It totally works. And these that I got the exposure wrong on worked. The thread for the detail shots. And then we get into these, all done with an 80D and 18 to 135. This is where some studio lights would come in handy. But then just using the natural light coming in from outside, and then pa-pow, pa-pa-pow, boom, boom. And that's all she wrote. That's it, guys. That's my editing process. I'll probably go back and tweak some of these tomorrow when I see them in the light. Even though we're in the light, I've got my Kino Flows on to give me daylight editing stuff with. That's going to be it. Check out the 5-minute portrait up here on the screen that I did with these guys. Well, at Norman Porter. Go to normanporter.com if you want really good American-made jeans by hand. He made them. He cuts them. They sew them. They rivet them. It's freaking awesome that they make it all themselves. Incredible. Yeah, what I have to say, I'm happy with the shots. I wish some of them were just slightly tighter where they were. But then again, that's 1-to-1. If you were ever to print them out as 24 by 36s, you probably wouldn't notice too much. If they're subtly out, I hate that they're subtly out, some of them. But I think I'm pretty happy with the photo story right here. Pretty happy with the photos that I captured. I hope you guys enjoyed watching this long-ass freaking video. Like I say, if I'm going to edit them, I'll put on the record. I'll hit record and let you guys watch. That's it. That's it. Thank you. That's it. Please subscribe to my channel. If you haven't signed up for the Photos Photo email list, just look for the orange box over on the website. Put your name, email address in it, hit send it. I'll send you a free guide to capturing motion in low light situations. If you want to learn how I capture images similar to these, check out photosphoto.com/guide, where I give you 3 hours of understanding of how to shoot, well, basically how to get out of auto and use the exposure triangle to your advantage so that you can understand how to capture images just like this. That is a $67 guide. It helps support the channel. It helps support what we continue to do to give you this free video. I have to say that between an hour and a half, however long the actual photo shoot is that we put out, and this hour and some minute video, I mean, this is like 3 hours of content that you're going to get just about this one photo shoot, breaking it down. If you want to download the full res JPEGs over on the website, download sampled raw files over on the website. But pick up my video guides. That's how you support the channel. That's how we continue to go on. Go to Squarespace, work with everybody we work with. If you like what we do, support what we do, and that's how we can continue to make bigger and better content. You guys watch it. We'll keep creating it, and I'm going to leave it at that. Thank you guys very much. Don't forget to subscribe here on YouTube and as well on Facebook. Jared Polin, FronosPhoto.com. See ya.